Can do. You know, you're sitting with your parents. Parents don't slow down the car for a woman with three children trying to cross the road. How are you going to create empathy? I think it permeates beyond schooling. It's a state of mind, as Dr. Sinha rightly said. And schools are an important ingredient, but not the only one to create that. In fact, this is something I have myself said in one of my books called Don't Sprint the Marathon. The problem with our educational system and parenting system is we never tell a child that it's all right to fail, that it is fine to fail as long as you learn from the failing. In fact, we create a sense of failure in a child who got only 80% marks and not 96% marks, and there's a sense of failure. But we never tell a child that if last time you got 60%, this time you got 75%, you've done better than yourself. And that's the way to go. I think preparing our children how to learn from failure should be an important ingredient of education. But I do believe in recent times the government has tried to introduce some elements of that, saying that examinations should be more, you know, that there have to be some improvements in the examination system and so on. But I still entirely agree that we have to explicitly work towards failure management, because there is nobody in the world who is successful without having failed at some stage or other. The difference is someone learns from failures and someone doesn't.
Very few words. I think Dr. Shanta Sinha had said something very, very interesting while she was talking. She said, let the children be children. Today's education system, especially in the elite schools, is taking the childhood out of a child. You drive them from the school to the tuition, to the tennis class, to the swimming class. The child has no time to be curious. The child has no time to learn. They grow up learning to hate differences, like what happened yesterday night. Some kids beat up a child from Arunachal Pradesh or something, because we are not really creating a system where a child in whose heart love is intrinsic is not allowed to remain a child. We take it away. We say competition, dog eat dog world is what it's all about. You have no time to give a hand to somebody else who's fallen. Help him and go along the way. So it's this that we have to bring in. The subjective component in the education system has to go up a good deal more. We still may not be able to say whether the subjective part should be 80% or 20%, because it's subjective by definition. But I do think that our education system has to be more in terms of competition with yourself, doing better than what you do instead of doing better than somebody else, which is all about differences and hating differences, and not preparing you to excel yourself in terms of what best you can do yourself. I think that is a short answer I can think of.